الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بعد، one of the pillars of Islam, one of the pillars of Islam is to fast the month Ramadan. And as you know, now we are in Rajab, about 40 days or 37 days, Ramadan is coming. So one of the important things, number one, if you missed something from last Ramadan, try to make up the missed days now. Alhamdulillah, the weather is nice, the day is short, the night is long, and you can take the advantage, you know, if there is an off, okay, for the qada, no problem. Even if you fast Friday, no problem with that. Even if you fast Saturday, no problem with that. And there is a vacation for many places the coming weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Then after 2 weeks, we have, the 25th, 26th of February. I mean, do the qada as soon as possible. And remind your wife and your daughters. Remind your wife, your daughters. And this is one of the important points, brothers, that sometimes we forget or we ignore our daughters. She is maybe 12 years old, but she is an adult. She is baligh. Maybe she is kid in our eyes. She is a child in our eyes. But in Sharia, she is baligh. When she starts the period, she is baligh, pubert. She has to fast. She has to pray. She has to wear the hijab. Okay? So one of the points, Ramadan. Make sure with your daughter, how many days she missed last Ramadan. Let's do it now. And maybe you can help your daughter, that all the family to fast. Maybe she's feeling difficult. She's the only one fasting. But imagine if the whole family fasting. Of course, I fast with the intention of sunnah, for example, after a few days Sha'ban, I'm fasting Sha'ban, to sunnah to fast Sha'ban. طيب. So the main thing is to make up the missed days before the coming Ramadan. Why? Because many questions we hear from the mashayikh, to the scholars, Sheikh, I missed 7 days from last Ramadan and now only 2 days left. What can I do? Is it enough to pay some kafara? Subhanallah, where are you? 11 months not enough to fast only 7 days? This is subhanallah from the shaitan. Why? Because Eid day, after the Eid day, someone is biting me here, there. Okay, you finish 1 week from the food. You don't have a time to make up the missed days. This is very important and this is fard. Another point, because also Ramadan is coming, it is very important to learn what are the rules of Ramadan. Prepare yourself for Ramadan, okay? If there is a course, if there is a series of lectures, there is a book, try to learn what are the rules of Ramadan, mustahabbat, wajibat. It takes maybe few hours. If you take a book, maybe it takes 2-3 hours to go through the book. Or if there is a course, learn about Ramadan. We should learn about Ramadan because this is one of the pillars of Islam. Another thing, different topic, which is regarding the masjid. The masjid is the responsibility of the whole community. The imam, the muaddin, the men, the women, everyone. Hadith in Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw something on the wall. Which one? The direction of the Qibla. He saw a sputum. Someone spat on the wall. Qibla direction. And it was dry. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam removed that with his finger. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, فحكها بأصبعه. He removed that dirt It is not najis, but it is a dirt, something we don't like. And he was not, he was upset, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to see that in the qibla of the masjid. So there are many rules of this hadith, but I like to focus on the point, as Ibn Hajar rahimullah mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the imam of the Muslim ummah, the messenger of Allah, he took the responsibility to clean that. So this is my point, that the masjid is the responsibility of the whole community. Especially, you know, when there is a crowd in the masjid. Yes, the ministry in some masajid, they put two cleaners. And if it's a small masjid, one cleaner. But the issue is not with the size of the masjid, the issue of the crowd in the masjid. Maybe it's a small masjid, but many people in the five prayers, mashallah. And he cannot do that. Very difficult for him. He needs to work 20 hours maybe. So we should help. And everyone knows the hadith that the woman who used to clean the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when she passed away, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked, where is that woman? Where is that woman? They told him she passed away. Why did not tell me? I should do the janazah. Subhanallah. So the woman was taking the mission of cleaning the masjid. So this is very important that we should take care of the masjid. No, there is someone. He should take. Where is the muaddin? We go outside and we knock the door. Why you are not cleaning? Why the chairs are like that? Subhanallah. This is also our responsibility, the masjid. You will get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should learn what are the manners of the masjid. You know, the scholars wrote books about the manners, the etiquettes of the masjid. Masjid Baytullah. Baytullah. It is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The masjid is the house of every righteous person. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Masjid Bayt Kul Taqi. The masjid is the house of every pious, righteous. Subhanallah. What is the meaning of that? If there is an issue, you come to the masjid. This is your home. You have a fight with your wife, you come here. You are feeling sad, bad, you come to the masjid. Not to the coffee, not to the camp, not you book a ticket and you travel to a country for the weekend. You come to the masjid. This is the place of the righteous people. The masjid was the place of fatwa for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the companions. They do the classes in the masjid. And of course the prayers, the dua in the masjid. So we should know what are the etiquettes of the masjid, the Bayt of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last thing I like to remind myself, I remind you to keep the dua, to keep your brothers and sisters in your dua everywhere, subhanallah, or many places in the Muslim, in the world, the Muslims are suffering. Every day, maybe in Gaza, 150, 200 people killed, subhanallah. They don't care. They speak about humanity, but they are against that. They speak about humanity when you kill one of them or you kill one animal from them. But to kill the Muslims, subhanallah, very cheap. Okay, we need to make dua for them. And we need to work hard to make the Muslim ummah very strong. We should think, brothers and sisters, how to make the Muslim ummah strong? How? When I work for myself to make money and to grow my business, we should work hard for the Muslim ummah. It should be in my heart, the Muslim ummah. Today, Gaza. Tomorrow, we don't know. And Muslim in Sudan, Muslim in Borno, Muslim in Philippines, many places. Mentioned in the media or not mentioned, the Muslims are killed. Subhanallah. This is not something new. We should think how to improve the Muslim, how to make the Muslim ummah strong. We should unite on the tawheed. This is very important, not only to unite, because many times people say, we should unite. This is not enough. We should unite on the tawheed, the haqq. Because what is the point to unite on dalala, misguidance, and bid'ah? No, we should unite on the sunnah. Allah says, wa'tasimu bihablillah. The robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, the sunnah, not only to unite. We should know to unite on what? The Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect our Muslims every way. We should ask Allah to unite the Muslim Ummah on the Haqq. Jazakumullah khair. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.